Gordon Nuttall is tonight adjusting to prison life. He's begun a 7-year jail sentence for corruptly receiving $360,000 in secret commissions from two businessmen. But even Nuttall's own lawyer says his punishment could have been much worse. He'll be eligible for parole in 2.5 years. Francine Norton reports from Brisbane.
Gordon Nuttall made the grim journey from the Brisbane Watch House to the District Court today in the same suit he's worn since he was taken into custody 2 days ago.
Well, I think he's exhausted. He's been sleeping on an iron bed for 2 nights.
While the convicted criminal remained confined in his police van, his family found comfort in numbers as they ran the media gauntlet to hear his punishment. The sentence, 7 years. He'll be eligible for parole in 2.5. Chief District Court Judge Patsy Wolfe told Nuttall, the fact you were a Minister of the Crown is one of the gravest examples of receiving secret commissions.
You can't argue against that. I mean, he was in a position of real power, and that's why the maximum sentence was given.
But Nuttall escaped a cumulative sentence. Judge Wolfe took into account his cooperation with the prosecution and his family's public humiliation.
The argument is that there could have been something worse, I suppose, so you've got to look at that.
Unlike his emotional reaction to his guilty verdicts, Nuttall gave little away when he learned of his sentence. He simply closed his eyes and shook his head. As he was led out of the courtroom, Nuttall shouted to his family, "Love you all." Political reaction was unsympathetic.
This is a long time in a jail cell. These are the sort of crimes that go to the heart of public trust in our system of government.
I don't know anyone who's got 7 years from the Fitzgerald inquiry. This is an extremely serious matter from a senior minister.
From prison van to prison clothes, Nuttall was whisked away from court to the Wolston Correctional Centre at Wakehall, west of the city. Nuttall will undergo an induction program and live in a single cell alongside more than 500 other inmates.
He'll have a long time to reflect on the activities that he's been involved in.
There's also the possibility of further charges for official corruption.